butterfly. Before coming to America, I was a member of the Conservation Club of Butterflies. We protected their eggs and larvae from birds or bees. This was a private club made by my two friends, myself and our kids. It was a small club, but we worked very well. Every year, the activities started in spring and continued till the early fall. When I heard someone found eggs in some place, we rushed there and picked them up and never forgot to get some soft leaves for expected baby larvae to eat. We were trying to pick eggs up, not larvae, because in many cases, it is too late to save them. Sadly, they were already parasitic by some insects like bees in high rate. Even if it were eggs, nobody knew if they were still safe or not. Moreover, we had to pay attention which leaves we should choose as their food. Once they start to eat some kind of leaves, they seldom change the kind of leaves. So, if I found the eggs on some rare tree, I wouldn't pick the leaves from that tree. Because they really eat a lot, I wouldn't be able to find enough leaves to feed them. My daughter Mao and I had enjoyed watching butterflies' lives. They grew up very fast, and they were so dramatic beyond the expression. Especially the part of metamorphosis to chrysalises and butterflies were amazing. My family came to the United States after Mao graduated from her elementary school when she was 12. Since she was so sweet, kind, and smart that everybody couldn't stop loving her. She was always a leader in her classes and had many friends. Everything was going smoothly as she wanted. She was in the perfect world for her, till coming to America. I had been thinking that the culture shock would be almost nothing for her, because she knew how to communicate well. But it was totally different. The culture shock defeated her. Everything was different from what she had thought. I hadn't noticed that her communication skill was based on words. She had always been talking and talking and talking what she had been thinking. But as soon as she came to America, she lost words, not only friends. Larvae molt over and over while they are growing up. Before molting, they stopped moving. I thought Mao looked like that at her severe period. She needed time to molt. Two years have passed. There is a chrysalis in my house. I mean it's Mao. She has molted several times to grow up. And now she has a lot of friends and really enjoying American life. This year, she is studying very, very hard every day to preparing for going back to Japan. While taking care of larvae or butterflies, we saw a lot of impressive scenes, but also worried about them a lot. Sometimes they stopped eating. That made us confused. They need enough time to transfer to chrysalises and spend about 2 weeks to become butterflies. After getting out from their chrysalises, they also need a whole day for drying their wings before flying. During the time I was watching Mao struggle in new culture, I remember those butterflies we had taken care of together. They were flying away from our fingers. Now I can see Mao moving in her chrysalis. I know it's a sign she is almost going out to fly with her own wings. I'd like to tell her I am really proud of her and take enough time before flying. I wish she could choose a warm, sunny, and calm day.